Hey, Chris, this is Robert Ian with ConquerChange.com. There has been some limited discussion in mainstream media about the apparent mistake made by the Fed in accidentally publishing internal staff forecasts for interest rates, unemployment, and other key indicators on their website late last month. Typically, the Federal Reserve waits 5 years to publish such information. But in what is being called a slip-up, staff forecasts were added to the Fed's public site on June 29th. So not only have officials been able to evaluate this data, everyone else with a laptop and an internet connection can as well. What you'll find is the following. The Fed expects the federal funds rate to be at 0.35% by the end of this year. Rates are seen rising to 1.26% by the end of 2016, and then rising to 2.12% by the end of 2017. By the end of 2020, the rate is expected to be 3.34%. What a great way to front-run and psychologically manage interest rate expectations than to inadvertently release them in advance for the next 5 years. Accidents like this do not happen on this level. In a MarketWatch article, Stephen Stanley, chief economist at Amherst Pierpont Securities, was quoted as saying, "As I look at the forecast, I can't help but conclude all of these PhD economists on the board staff are wasting a lot of time running these models. How can real growth exceed potential by over 0.5% for the next 3 years, but the unemployment rate magically stabilizes at exactly the full employment level?" The model released by the Fed shows that the staff is forcing the model to split out forecasts that show upcoming inflation under 2%. He commented, "Do you get the impression, as I do, that the staff gathers in a room and decides what the results should be, and then tortures the model, or at least uses fudge factors until they get to the results that they were determined to achieve? Why bother with extensive, complicated models if you are just going to manipulate the result? Because the model provides at least the illusion of rigor and objectivity." The illusion of rigor and objectivity. That's exactly what it is, an illusion. This model reminds me of a mind-reading trick I bought in the 1970s, when they started selling scientific calculators. Three people would each randomly input a four-digit number into a calculator. A fourth person would then total their inputs and announce the randomly derived number, which was a five-digit number. The first two numbers in the sequence represented a page number. The second two numbers represented a line number. The third number represented a position from left to right. There were a stack of books on the table. The person picked up a book, opened it to that page, counted down to that line, and counted across to that word. When the person announced the word, it matched a word that was pre-written on a blackboard and was revealed at that moment. a pretty amazing illusion for the 1970s, but it's easy when you know how it's done. The calculator was gimmicked. It was hotwired so that it could be pre-programmed, so that no matter what numbers were input, they always came out with the predetermined 5-digit answer that was used to identify one particular word in the book. I'm happy to share that simple magician's method with you because the psychological levels of sophistication since the 1970s have advanced significantly to the point where that same illusion can fool you many times over today, because the methods are so much more sophisticated and refined. But let's refocus on the Fed's somewhat antiquated and unbelievable financial models for the information they supposedly, inadvertently released. Are their methods convincing or fooling anyone? I think not. Will they use these to posture against in each of the coming years? Of course. But it's a worn-out magic trick that is going to fool less and less people as time goes on, because we are facing significant debt issues the world over that eventually cannot be papered over. They can for now, it seems, but that will only last until it can't. And that day is getting closer by the minute. Remember, there are lies, damned lies, and those inadvertently released Fed projections. You be the judge. Chris, I'd like to urge all of our listeners to sign up for my email list at conquerchange.com. Several years ago, our listeners will recall I hosted a series of teleseminars on gold and the economy, and I'll soon begin hosting a series of free Conquer Change webinars. So please sign up at conquerchange.com, and until next time, this is Robert Ian, reminding you to follow us on Twitter @ConquerChange. Thanks, Chris.